Let's take two people who have both been diagnosed with cancer. Joe, he's age 45, Caucasian, diagnosed with colorectal cancer that's being treated with chemotherapy. He remains relatively well during treatment and is able to continue working. Bill, he's also in his 40s. He's also Caucasian, diagnosed with that same form of colorectal cancer that's being treated with the same type of chemotherapy. Well, he requires hospitalization and is at risk of major infection due to severe diarrhea and other side effects. Additionally, he has worse long-term prospects as his cancer treatment needs to be stopped while these side effects are dealt with. So why do these two, on paper, very similar people have vastly different responses to treatment? And is the answer in, of all places, their poo? Chemotherapy is the most common form of treatment for cancer in Australia, yet largely it's a one-size-fits-all approach, leading to a myriad of side effects. Up to 80% of people will develop diarrhea, with some being hospitalised with an infection. Up to 7% of those people will die directly due to that infection, so not even due to the cancer itself. So there's a clear need here for a way to personalise chemotherapy treatment in order to reduce risk of these life-impacting side effects. I'm breaking down this wall by developing pre-treatment gut microbial profiling tests. The gut microbiome, the millions of bacteria and other microorganisms living in your intestine, are as unique to you as your fingerprint, and they play a key role in determining your risk of developing diarrhea or an infection. Using a stool sample, we can extract bacterial DNA, which is then sequenced, giving us a readout of all of the types of bacteria living in your intestine. I'm developing a predictive model where a person's pre-treatment microbial DNA profile and other demographic information can be input, allowing us to quantify a person's risk of developing severe diarrhea or an infection. And as a proof of concept, in my current clinical trial, initial pilot results have shown that people with high levels of the bacteria Blautia have a lowered risk of developing severe diarrhea. Once we have this information, cancer treatment can be modified to provide a more optimal treatment plan. As well as moderating the dose and schedule of treatment, a specified probiotic mix could be given to alter a person's microbial profile towards a profile with a lower risk. Overall, we think that these microbial DNA profiling tests will be a quick, cheap, and easy way of ensuring that both Joe and Bill have the same chance to continue living life both during and beyond cancer treatment.